Hello. Today we're going to take a short flight in the Grumman G44 Eidgeon. As you can see, it's an amphibian. An aircraft that reminds me of some of the Biggles stories that I read avidly in my youth. Biggles and his team flew an amphibian somewhat like the Eidgeon. I don't remember what it was called. Maybe I'll Google it. Let's just show you where we are. On Google Maps. So here's Land's End Airport. I'll be taking off on this runway. And then we're going to bank right. Take a little look at Senan Beach and Senan Beach and Senan Cove. And then I'll fly left, land in the sea and come back over Land's End. A couple of websites, just do a search on images of St. Just Airport. There's the airport website. St. Just mainly serves the Scilly Isles. This is ukairfields.org.uk with photographs of the buildings and such. And the GA magazine, Pilot. A little bit of information and some comments. And a wiki page, which I found interesting. Because they used to fly De Havilland Dragons from here. And I had a De Havilland Dragon, a DH-84, not a real one, in FSX, the predecessor to Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. So let's get in the cockpit. Just take a little look around. See the wear and tear. Maximum luggage 20 pounds in the front there. And the throttle overhead and some of the controls, switches and so on above us. So let's get going, let's get in the air. I'm not sure if the parking brake is on or off. Pull for on, push for off, so it's off. Open the throttle wide. And off we go. Doesn't take very long to get in the air, because there is a very high wind. Probably higher than is safe. Good look at the airport buildings as we get going. Senan Cove, or Senan Beach, Guinea Beach, and Senan Beach, and Senan Cove. And we came here, we camped nearby. And there's a great cafe just by the car park there, before the houses. And it's up high above the beach, so you can get some refreshments there, sit and look out across the cove and survey the sea. Watch the world go by. Then on our left, that's Land's End. And there are some rocky outcrops just out to the southwest of Land's End. You can see in front of us. Let's go and have a closer look. Since this is an amphibian, we'll just lift the gear down. gear is up. We can throttle the back. Put some flaps on. Slow the aircraft down. And drop in for a landing. Sort of close to these rocky outcrops. Now, you wouldn't normally land in the sea in these conditions. It's quite choppy. The sea would swamp this aircraft. But the AI isn't quite up to working out the impact of the individual waves on a flying boat. So we'll be safe enough. There we are, we're in. Now we're a boat. Slow down, and I'm not going to hang around here. We're looking into the sun, we can't see much. Let's just have a look outside here, which have been swamped by the waves. Here, the next one might go right over the top. Okay, let's just open the throttle and get going again. Doesn't take very long to get unstuck. It almost leaps into the air. Great power to weight ratio. Imagine, there's a boat in front of us. So we'll just bank left. Climb up over the cliffs. Have a look at Land's End. About the main building. I have been there, but I don't remember what it looked like. Might well have been like that, might well be like that. Certainly the hut at the end there is about right. That's where you stand to have your photograph taken, get somebody to take a photograph. Next to a sign that says New York, 1,000 and something odd miles. To let the control tower know that we want to land. Most of all, stop landing.
Tower Romeo Echo Sierra Charlie Uniform Echo 400 feet to land.
Romeo Echo Sierra Charlie Uniform Echo Tower. Altimeter tree 0.12 wind 161.41. Enter left downwind runway 16.
Make left traffic runway 16 Charlie Uniform.
Now, if I've pointed the aircraft in the right direction, we should see the airfield shortly. Left as instructed. Wait for clearance to land.
Charlie Uniform, Echo Wind 161.41. Clear to land runway 16.
Clear to land runway 16, Charlie Uniform Echo.
Now we're a bit too close. 70 knots airspeed, but I think there's a 40 knot headwind. Not ideal conditions. The taxi speed.
Charlie, Uniform Echo, turn next taxiway.
So that's what we're going, following the yellow line. Signposted A. To stop as soon as I throw them back.
Charlie, Uniform Echo, turn next taxiway. Charlie, Uniform Echo, contact ground on 120.255.
I just acknowledge the handoff, the ground handoff.
Going to 120.255, Charlie, Uniform Echo.
Oh. The aircraft. Oh, look, there's some people. Turn the engines off. Sounds like they're still going. Don't know where the mixture control is on this. Oh no, they're stopped. We're stopped. So, turn the battery off. Turn the avionics off. Thanks for watching.